Hi, my name is Charles Trin, and I'm the Strength and Conditioning Specialist at FunctionWorks Fitness. Today, we're going to talk about exercise for our senior population. But before we start, let me ask you one question. What do you think is the most important exercise that any senior can do? So I'll take a few seconds for you to think about that. Okay, you got it? The number one most important form of exercise that a senior can do is actually resistance training. When I was going through graduate school, one of our class projects was to figure out through research what is the most important form of exercise for anybody in general. And there's yoga, Pilates, aerobics, running, biking, swimming. Then everyone in our class came to the same consensus. The most important exercise that any individual can do is actually resistance training. And today, we're going to talk about the benefits of resistance training for our senior population. So why is resistance training important? The number one reason why resistance training is important is because as we age, our body's ability to generate strength and power starts to decrease over time. So after the age of 30, our bone mineral density starts to decrease, our strength levels start to decrease. Basically, use it or lose it. And what happens is, as we start aging, we start getting weaker, we're more prone to diseases and conditions such as osteoporosis, diabetes, and our risk of falls increases. So that increases the risk for injuries. By going and doing resistance training, you basically go and slow all of that down. So that's one of the major factors of why our seniors should go and do resistance training. So you might be thinking, what is resistance training? Resistance training is anything that involves lifting any external load. So you don't have to go to a gym. You don't have to have specialized equipment. You could be doing all of this at home. So if you just had like some small dumbbells, or even if you had a backpack or your grandchildren's books, you could use that as a form of resistance training, and you can go and make your body stronger. Because if your body is stronger, you'll have a better quality of life. And that's what we all want. Okay, so today I'm gonna go and show you one exercise that's gonna be really, really important to go and build bone mineral density, and that's going to be the sit to stand. So one good exercise that we can do to improve our lower body strength as well as increase our bone mineral density is exercise that we call sit to stand. And basically what the sit to stand is going to be a bodyweight squat. So what you want to do is you want to go and get a sturdy chair. Remember, you don't want anything that's not sturdy or something with wheels on it. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go position yourself, keep your toes pointed out slightly, feet are roughly hip width apart, but the most important thing is whenever you're doing this exercise, it should feel comfortable for you. So one thing you have to remember is whenever you're doing an exercise, if you feel any type of pain, you need to stop. What I'm talking about is pain within your joints. You don't wanna go and think that pain as in muscles is bad. That's gonna be natural for you to feel that type of pain, the burn that most people talk about. But when you start feeling it in your back, your hips, your knees, or your ankles, sharp pain, that's something that's basically telling you, okay, I need to stop. You need to go and talk to your doctor to see if this exercise is right for you. So very, very important to keep that in mind and always take your time and ask yourself, how does this feel, okay? So again, toes are pointed slightly out, feet are roughly hip width apart, and what you're gonna do is you're just gonna go and shove your hips back, keep your arms out, and you're just gonna go and squat all the way down to the chair, and then you're gonna go and stand all the way up. Just like that. So this is called the sit to stand. So what if this chair is, what if this exercise is too hard for you? What do you think you should do? What you can do is make it easier by finding a chair that's gonna be higher. So your range of movement, range of motion is actually decreased. So you're not moving as much. So as that gets easier for you, then you can start lowering the height of the chair, and that can increase the difficulty. Once you have a solid foundation of just doing body weight squats, you're gonna go and grab a dumbbell, or you can go and grab two dumbbells to increase the resistance. And what you could do is you could hold it right here in front of you and do the exact same movement, up and down. The added benefit of doing it with external resistance is that it will go and increase the bone mineral density in your spine and your hips and your legs. Okay? So we just looked at the front view of the sit to stand exercise. Now we're gonna go over a side view of the sit to stand exercise. So what you don't see from the front that I'm gonna do on the side is that as I'm sitting, I wanna go and put my butt back. Imagine you're looking for a seat, sticking your chest out and squatting straight down. Notice how when I'm doing this, my entire back is straight and I'm not rounding, okay? Rounding your back is really bad. You're gonna go and potentially herniate a disc. You'll cause back issues. So you always wanna think, stick the chest out, look for the seat behind you. Up and down, just like that. Another mistake that a lot of individuals do when they're doing a sit to stand exercise is that when they're squatting, they squat like this. Notice how my hips do not displace backwards. When you're doing it like this, you're putting a lot of stress on the knees, and that's something we don't want to do. We want to go and keep the knees roughly right over the front of our toes, okay? So you don't want your knees going too far forward. Just like this. So this is wrong. This is correct. That's a sit to stand exercise. I want to thank all of you guys very much for taking out the time to go and watch this video. So remember, the most important exercise that you can do for yourself to improve the quality of your life and increase your bone mineral density and go and control other types of illnesses is actually resistance training. And if you have any questions, please feel free to contact me at functionworksfitness.com. My phone number is 808-779-1604. Please let me know if you have any questions and how I can serve you. Thank you.